Out of all existing Disney cartoons, there was one moment that has always captivated me. It was the one episode where Donald Duck finally stood up to the oppression of Nazi Germany and said, "This, for me, is the most wonderful display of how revolution has to happen."
Belle Delphine is back, and my god, her new video is truly symptomatic for this new, time that we live in. It truly fascinates me how blatantly she screams her money-making tactics into the camera. That, for me, shows that she's totally aware of her own ideology. And while she is mocking it herself, the ideology still, survives. She literally says, "Are you dumb?" to her fans. And what is YouTube's response? Thousands of reaction videos. This is, for me, a classic response of mutualism, where the people who are reacting to the video are only doing so as a pure excuse to use Miss Delphine's face in the thumbnail.
"But you have to understand, these young men are resentful because they never made the attempt to climb the dominance hierarchy and, you know, if you're pursuing big tech energy, that's just wrong!"
Your efforts to revive Hegelianism will soon pay off. This is wonderful.
Now, quickly tell you a joke a guy from Montenegro once told me. You know, there's this cliché that all people from Montenegro are incredibly lazy, which, you know, isn't a cliché, but anyways, the joke goes. There is a group of Montenegrins on the beach, and they're out there in the water is a guy who's drowning, shouting for help. "Oh my god, I'm drowning, please help me." And the group of guys standing on the beach begins to talk. Guy A says to the other one, "You know, this guy is drowning." "Yes," replies guy B, "definitely he's drowning." Then guy A responds with, "You know, and we are just standing here." Guy B, "Yes, we are standing. Why don't we just sit down?"
I would sell my mother into slavery for a movie called B-Movie 2.
You might know this Irish guy, Jacksepticeye, launched his new coffee brand. And I was about to place an order when I was suddenly faced with a major dilemma. I noticed that he also offers his coffee as cold brew, black coffee, no? I then had to write an email to him to ask him whether this is coffee without milk or coffee without cream. I need to know what it negates in order to know what I would be about to order.
You know, it's always fascinated me, Red Bull. This company has been founded by an Austrian guy called Dietrich Mateschitz. You might have heard about him. He's basically the richest person in Austria right now. And you might say now, oh, it is known and loved all around the world, so this is okay. But the thing that always strikes me is, can you think of an even more unfortunate name for your capitalist drink than Red Bull? This name that promises to be of a communist nature ends up to be completely misleading. For me, this is a wonderful example of how you can cheat with ideology. The drink implies to be red, but it ends up just being the bull. Back in the day, I saw this movie called Elvin and the Chipmunks, and many of you who have seen it might think now, ah yes, this stupid children's movie. No. Did you notice that Elvin, who is clearly the alpha rodent in this trio, is always wearing a red sweater? And by now you might be thinking, you know, this is a guy, my god, this is pure and total madness. But let me show you, in comparison, two pictures, and you tell me in full honesty if you don't see any resemblance here.